Today, I have a tutorial based around magazine layout in Adobe InDesign, both for print and web use. That's coming right up now. How's it going, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics. I hope you're doing well today. I've had to move from 6 uploads per week down to 5 uploads because I simply cannot make decent content for 6 days a week whilst being a graphic designer. There aren't enough hours in the day. So now the only days I'm not going to be uploading are Saturday and Sunday. Today, however, thanks to another subscriber suggestion, we'll be looking at Adobe InDesign in both layout and export for magazine use. This is going to be a long tutorial, and I know many of my subscribers will most likely not even use Adobe InDesign that often, but I do like to cover a wide range of areas of graphic design on this channel. So if you're not a fan of Adobe InDesign, don't fret. I have more Illustrator and Photoshop tutorials, as well as much more in the pipeline. There's a list of time stops in the corner if you want to see specific points of this tutorial. If you do find this tutorial helpful, let me know in the comment section below and subscribe to Satori Graphics if you haven't done already. Setting up a layout for your magazine for web use is slightly different than that of print. When you create the document, you can elect to generate it for web use here. However, like in my most recent web publication, link in the description below, I used a print document and you shall see why next. For this magazine, I used a typical A4 double page spread for a number of pages. If this was a print project, and you will see later in this Adobe InDesign tutorial, I would only design the artwork in Photoshop and add the text and logo files in InDesign. But seeing as this is for web use, I don't have to worry about the text being printed blurry as it's for screen use only. So with that in mind, I created everything in Photoshop and then transferred the files over to InDesign. I simply created an A3 landscape document at 300 ppi in Photoshop. And then split them in half for my magazine pages. Once I've done that, I can then create my artwork on here for the magazine, the left section being the left page and the right section being the right page. Once happy, I flatten each side and save them individually as JPEGs. Then back in InDesign, I use the box tool and place my files by going up to File and then Place. For exporting a magazine for web use, you have a few different choices depending on what you want to do with it. For example, an SWF file will have a page turn animation like so. The client for this magazine, however, wanted to use the interactive PDF version. Make sure you select spreads and select all. Use a JPEG lossy setting as well as a maximum output. This worked fine for me, and you can view the magazine in the link in the description below. Next, we will cover how to set up a magazine for print in Adobe InDesign, which is a little more detailed and in-depth. Now let's set up an InDesign document for magazine layout for print. Go up to a file, a new document. For print, we obviously need to select the print option here. And for the number of pages, you will need to put however many pages you want for your magazine, but also taking into account the front and back page. We can add or delete pages easily at the later stage. Here we can put in the size of each individual page, and I'm going to run with A4 for today. And then the orientation, i.e. either landscape or portrait. For columns, I often use 3 for magazine work, but some people may like to use 2 or even 4 columns. It is completely up to the designer. And then you want to use a 3mm bleed that is added around the entire document. If your measurements are not in millimeter, you will need to close Adobe InDesign and reopen it, then go up to InDesign at the top left corner, preferences, and then measurements and increments. When your Adobe InDesign magazine document is generated, it should look something like this. The lines on the pages are just guides, and they're not going to be printed. To add or delete pages, go up to Layout, and then choose your options from here. Using my method for magazine design for print, I will then make my pages in Photoshop, or at least the artwork. By the artwork, I mean anything that isn't type or logos. You want to add the text and logos directly into Adobe InDesign, so that then they hold quality and do not become pixelated when printed. In Photoshop, I make an A3 document, and then we're going to rotate it 90 degrees landscape eventually. I generate it at 300 ppi, then I add a guide halfway down that splits it up into 2 sections, each one being A4. I then add guides to the edges to increase the document by 6mm each way that will compensate for the 3mm bleed in Adobe InDesign. The bleed is essential for printers as they will cut everything outside of the bleed, so keep your main content within the bleeds. Once I'm happy, I then crop each side and flatten them and save them as 2 individual JPEGs. Now back in Adobe InDesign, create a box across your page like so, and then go up to File and Place. Locate your file and then drop it in. It should fit perfectly in place like so. Hold down Alt until you see this icon up here to duplicate the box. Delete the image inside the box on the other side. Now we can start adding in our text using the box tool we used to add an image, and also import your logo files. Remember to select all of your text and go up to Create Outlines before you send the file to print. Alternatively, you can leave it as it is, and package the font files along with the Adobe InDesign document. To export for print, go up to File and Export. Select Adobe PDF Print, and then hit OK. Use the most recent version of Acrobat, and these are the settings I will use for this window. Under compression, I use these settings here for high quality print. And I select every single option apart from crop marks here. It is best to talk with your printing company before, as they may have specific settings for printing. In the summary section, if there are any warnings about your magazine document, they will be flagged here. Once complete, export and you should have a preview of it open up in Adobe Acrobat. So did you find my tutorial on how to create a magazine layout in Adobe InDesign helpful? If so, let me know in the comment section below and drop a like on your way out. Subscribe to Satori Graphics to keep updated to all of my 5 uploads per week. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.